Hi, this is Andy Cobb with the Intel Corporation. In this video, I will be going over how you can use Intel Endpoint Management Assistant or Intel EMMA to manage devices in your environment. Let's take a look at some of the features we have for the management of devices using Intel EMMA. First thing I would like to point out is that EMMA can manage Intel vPro and non-Intel vPro devices. Intel EMMA supports managing devices at the software level using a Windows agent when the operating system is up and has a network connection. However, for Intel vPro platforms, EMMA can manage using hardware out-of-band access to the system using Intel Active Management Technology or Intel Standard Manageability. And we are going to take a look at an example of how that works with this Intel NUC, which includes Intel AMT. When I bring up the device page for the NUC, we can see a few things. We see the system is powered on, and the software agent is connected. We also see that this device is connected via client-initiated remote access to our EMMA server. In this case, the device I'm managing is actually located on a different network, attached to a consumer broadband connection, which is communicating to the EMMA instance that is running up in the cloud. Here you can see a number of tabs at the top of the screen. We have Hardware Manageability, Desktop, Terminal, Files, Processes, and WMI. Let's start with the Hardware Manageability tab. This is where all the hardware level manageability happens. Clicking on the tab displays some basic information about the system, such as the firmware version that is running, that the device is powered on and is plugged in, and some basic capabilities to be able to turn certain features or functions on and off. Note, the listed capabilities will vary between Intel Active Management Technology and Intel Standard Manageability. Let's go and take a look at the fun stuff, and that is the Hardware Remote Desktop function, which is only supported on Intel AMT. This is sometimes also called KVM, Remote Control. And this is where I can manage a device at a hardware level just like I was in front of it. This is the same experience you have with software management, but at a hardware level. And to demonstrate that, I'm going to reboot this system. And with software-based management tools, once the operating system stops running, the remote management stops, and you have to ask the person that you are assisting to describe what is happening over the phone, with questions like, "What is going on? Can you read me the error message?" You do not have to worry about that with the hardware management using Intel AMT. Here, I am able to reboot the system, watch a post, and come up through the entire process. If there are errors that pop up, I will see those, just like I was in front of the system itself. In this demo, I am loading Windows back up normally, and I will be able to watch our end user log back in and help them with any other problems they have. So, that is the basic idea with the Intel Out-of-Band Management Technology and Intel AMT. I have the ability to manage these devices at a hardware level in ways that we are not able to with software-based agents on their own. So, now we have had a quick preview of what we can do with Intel AMT, let's take a look at some of the other tabs we have. I will start with the Desktop tab. This brings up the same remote control experience you saw with Intel AMT, but at a software level. You get a little bit of a performance benefit when using software remote management. Things work a little smoother, but it does require that the OS is up and running along with supporting components needed to access the internet. If you need to reboot the system to do pre-OS diagnostics, you can use Remote Desktop inside of Hardware Manageability and watch the system reboot and do all your diagnostics just like you are in front of the device. And then switch to the Desktop tab to get a little faster experience when booted to the OS. The Terminal tab provides the ability to bring up a terminal. We can interface with the EMMA agent and bring up a command prompt. As demonstrated, I was able to run a directory listing on the remote device. In addition, I can start an AMT terminal session. Open the Actions drop-down menu. Select Start AMT Terminal. Open Actions drop-down menu again, select Power Cycle to BIOS. Here you can see the BIOS displayed. AMT Terminal is supported on both Intel Active Management Technology and Intel Standard Manageability Devices. The Files tab brings up a connection to the file system of the client to copy files back and forth. And again, this works through firewalls without having to have the system connected to VPN. Here is an example of where the files and desktop features can come into play. Imagine a scenario where I have a customer that is connected through VPN and the VPN software is no longer working. I can use the Files menu to upload a new VPN application or a new VPN certificate to that computer. Go to the desktop screen, connect to the device. Remember, this is all happening over the internet. Here, I can install the certificate or update the VPN software. I do not have to have a connection back to the corporate network to update the VPN software. After making the update or install of the VPN software, I ensure that the customer is able to get a connection back to the office and get back to work. The Processes and WMI tab do what you think they do. From the Processes tab, I can view a list of processes on the computer. Again, at the software level through the agent. I can launch or terminate processes here. Likewise, with WMI, I can run WMI queries against the remote system. This concludes the demonstration of the capabilities of Intel Endpoint Management Assistant. Thank you for watching and keep an eye out for the next video.